As a journalist, I ask lots of questions. Yes, lots of questions. So let me begin my presentation with a question. Someone was asking me about the mountains. Do you have mountains in the country? And I'm like, what? So my question is, which is the highest mountain in the world? The quiz question, yes. Everest. Mount Everest. Yes, you heard it right, and I'm from Nepal, all the way from Nepal. Thank you so much, Outriders, for inviting us here. I'm here with my co-founder, Kamal Kumar. Kamal Kumar. Kamal Kumar, he is right out there in the sixth row with his blue sweater and a cap. Okay, that's the man. So we co-founded Herne Katha. So let's begin our story. Okay, so before 2018, me and my co-founder, Kamal Kumar, we worked in different media organizations. We worked in mainstream media, we worked in print, we worked in broadcast media like radio and television. And the most exciting was the dream of almost all the journalists in my country to be in BBC. So we worked in BBC for about 8 years altogether. Yes, 8 years. And the man out there whom I was interviewing before 2018, he was the then Prime Minister. We interviewed lots of politicians. Yes, lots of politicians, leaders, elites. We talked to them. We heard so many promises. So many promises. And we forget all the hopes. We want to listen to their lies and promises that were never materialized. And we were quite unhappy about that. And one fine morning, me and my co-founder, Kamal Kumar, who was my friend as well from the career, from the day first of my career as a journalist and his career as a journalist, some 15 years ago. And we were the university friend as well. So we were having a glass of beer. Beer. That's beer? Yeah. Yes, we were having beer. But I guess that's a hangover from last night's party. We were, I think I should do this. We were drinking cup of tea, in fact. And that was the wrong slide. We were having cup of tea, and then we were having cup of discussions as well. So that was the magic realization during the time when we were having tea, not beer. We were having tea and we had that magic realization that we have to do something. We have to do something to really have that hopes in people. Just to keep continue what people are doing and forget all those lies, forget all those frustrations, forget all those promises. So that was the magic realization. We decided to quit our job at BBC. Okay, and then we had that magic realization and we quit the job that most of the journalists really wanted to have in the country. We decided to quit the job and BBC just to tell the stories of very common people, very ordinary people. And then Herne Katha was born. We travel around. We find people, we talk to them, we listen to their stories, we listen to their joys, we listen to their struggles, and they inspire us, and we bring their stories and their stories that inspire thousands and millions of people out there in Nepal. Okay, so Herne Katha, let me tell you, Herne means to watch. It's literally to watch. That's the Nepali language. So Herne means to watch in Nepali language. And Katha is story. So we tell the stories to watch. Of course, to listen as well. But because we speak the language of video, that's why these are the stories to watch. Yes. I'm not sure if it has got sound, but that's how we pronounce it. Herne Katha. Yeah. Yes. I'm done with this. Okay, so Herne Katha, it comes on YouTube every 15 days. Don't forget to watch it. Herne Katha, it comes on YouTube every 15 days, and it's around 25 to 30 minutes long. It's not that long. Not that long, 25 to 30 minutes only. And we bring lots and lots of inspiring stories. So, it's just 21 months. So, it's a startup. And 42 episodes. And we already have 200K subscribers in YouTube channel, which we haven't expected at the first place. While we started Herne Katha, we were really worried whether people will like it or not, how people will perceive our work. We were really worried about it, and we didn't figure it out until and unless our first episode was born. So when the first episode was out there, we were really nervous, really nervous. I'm not that nervous now, but we were really nervous. We were counting the time, and then people were, surprisingly, they gave us surprise. We were like overwhelmed with the message that we have got from the people, and that's when we realized people were really waiting for the kind of programs, for the kind of things that we are bringing in. So, the very first episodes, it was, we have thought that we will get 20,000 viewers and it will be enough for us, but then we got more than 50,000 viewers on the next day, and it was like awesome for us. We felt really happy, and now the viewerships and the subscription has gone very higher than our expectations. So what are the stories that we tell through Herne Katha? No bullshits. What do you think of bullshits? Bullshits. What is bullshits for you? The lies, the promises that was never materialized, those were the bullshits. So we don't talk politics. Politics means we don't talk events, we don't talk speeches, we don't talk false hopes that the politicians gives to the people, but no mainstream. We don't talk what mainstream media are talking about, but we talk what they are failing to talk to. So no power, no politics, no privilege, no elites. That's not Herne Katha. So what Herne Katha is, it's on the next slide. So what are the stories that we bring through Herne Katha? That's the stories of ordinary people, very common people who are living in the grassroots, in the remote part of the country. Nepal is a very diverse country, and we have like more than 100 ethnic groups and more than 100 different languages, so we try to reach each of those individuals out there who are living in the corners of the country. So we talk very small things, like joys and happiness of those people who think are of no one. They find themselves in the corner of the country, and no one, they don't think that their life and their life struggles matters. But for us, that matters a lot. So we talk very small things, the joys, struggles, happiness. We talk life of the people, life of the very ordinary people, very common people. Yes. So here, who do you think the leader is? The man out there, he is the then prime minister. The woman out there, we share the same name. She is Bidhya Vandari. I am Bidhya Chapagain. We share the same name, but she is the president of our country. And the one out there who is a local leader. So who is the leader for you? President? Prime Minister? For us, the one out there, the lady out there whom we have interviewed in Herne Katha, she is the one whom we interviewed. No one knew about her, but after Herne Katha, so many people were inspired by her stories. She was awesome, and she was the hero of her community, and we told the stories of Nirmala. That's her name. So We travel a lot, yes. We have been to almost all part of the country, almost all part, yes. We have got 77 districts in the country and we have been to each of them. But not for Herne Katha, of course, because it has just started, but we are aiming to. So where did we get money from? Money. That's the word that I really don't want to hear about. The word that I really don't want to talk about. But we have to, we don't have any options at all. So where did we get money from? Nowhere, literally nowhere for more than 16 months. Literally nowhere. For about like 16 months, we were self-funded. Me and Kamal Kumar, we emptied our pocket, in fact. But I would not say it's wrong because we had saved a lot working with BBC. So that was fine because this is the kind of work that has given us the optimum satisfaction. We were never of such satisfied. Like within these 21 months that we have started Herne Katha, there are not a single moment that we regret of the decision that we did some 21 months ago. So it was like, that's fine. We spend our money, that's fine. We will get it. We will get it later. We are not poor. We are here with outriders. Okay, so that was the story of 15 months, and the story has a little bit twist. A little bit twist in the next slide. Yes. So how did we make money now? For 6 months, revenue was zero. There was nothing because the YouTube channel it was not monetized. And even if it was monetized, Nepal is very small country for those kind of platform. So we have very little money from YouTube. I was talking about the cup of tea. So that was okay for cup of tea, but not for the glass of beer. So yeah, that's how it was for 6 months. And then started a little bit more, that was about $100 a month, and now our revenue from YouTube is almost like $600 for a month, so we are trying to improve it. I just have 4 minutes time, but I think I can go on. Yeah, okay, thank you so much, Jakob. I'm not bribing you. Okay. So that's how it is, like that's how our journey is. And then in the next slide, I will be talking about the love that we are getting from our people. We are getting lots and lots and lots and lots of love from our people. We are really inspired by all those messages that we get from our audience, all those interactions that they do in our programs. Please don't forget to go through the engagements. We really try to make sure that we read each of them and make sure to hit that like button out there. Yeah, and then there are hundreds of messages right out there in our inbox, eight to be read. And these are the kind of messages that we get. You can just read it. I will give you a few seconds. Smile. People are smiling. People are being happy. People are being sad. People have got like tears in their eyes. But they are inspired by the stories that we tell. And see, Bipendra Chetri, he is going to be a changed man. And that was just the power of people, the stories of ordinary people who were ignored by the mainstream media for a long, long time. And that's the gap that we fulfill. That's the gap that we really want to fulfill for the years, many, many years to come. Yeah. And we really get lots and lots of messages from our people and 62K real human-made comments on YouTube only, and we haven't counted Facebook and Twitter interactions because that's too much. That's too much, literally, yeah. If we just have like one questions in our Facebook page and in our Twitter or somewhere else in our platform, then there are hundreds of comments, and we try to have like each of them, but we haven't counted them all. Maybe Facebook, they need to, you know, figure out something to count all those comments. Yeah, so that's the kind of message that we get from. And then first, we're very shy. I'm right out here speaking, but I'm personally a very shy person. I talk to many people, but while talking about ourselves, it really makes me like very, very, I mean, you know, shy. I just want to hide myself into the corner. But these days, we are being the attraction for the mainstream media as well, because we have break that rules. Someone was asking me yesterday if I am best in Kathmandu, and I said like, oh, if I am best in Kathmandu, yes, I am best in Kathmandu. I work in Kathmandu, but there is this but. If I'm just best in Kathmandu, then I would not be able to break the thing that mainstream media are doing. We are not just staying in Kathmandu itself and talking about the politicians, talking about the elites, talking about all those crap things. We travel and talk to the people, real people, the grassroots, and we bring their stories. So mainstream media are kind of like now following what we are doing, and it's not just like what we are doing. They are not just interested in what we are doing, but they are interested in the kind of stories that we are doing. That means telling the stories of ordinary people. So this is like the major mainstream media telling our stories, but they are also telling the stories of the characters that we have done. Yeah, in the next slide, you can see like, you know, the story of love that the episode that we have made has made the headlines of the major English newspaper in the country. Yeah, so there is one more example out there. This is the video. That I would like to show.
I don't know if I'm going to go to the house.
Can you tell us what I've just shown you? So that was the girl living in the far western part of the country who was very hopeless, who was very frustrated, and who was regretting because she has got this life. And she was really angry with her mom that she has breastfed her instead of killing her. That's what she had shared with us. Yeah, that's her story. But she is a mind-blowing singer. She has such a beautiful voice. And then we discovered her someday in far western part of the country. She literally doesn't even have her own name. Her name is Jupri. Jupri literally means the one who lives in a hut, small hut. So she even doesn't have her name, and she is a blind woman. And this woman, after we interviewed her, after we told her stories to the world through Herne Katha, these people out there, the reality show, the major reality show in the country, they pointed her and they bring her to the stage. So that's how her life has been transformed. And now everyone knows her, everyone loves her, and she is about to bring an album very soon. So that's her story. So workflow, how we work. We research a lot because we have that background of being a journalist, turned to be a storyteller. So we research a lot, we travel a lot. That's the DNA, we travel a lot. We talk to people, yes. We talk to the real people and we find stories. We find stories through the people. Mm-hmm. And then filming, editing, post-production, pre-production, everything. Everything. And then there is this thing out there, reading comments that Bain was mentioning earlier. We literally read each and every of them, and I was mentioning that there are hundreds of messages out there in our Facebook page that we really want to hire someone to read those messages and reply them all. Yeah, we haven't been able to do that, but we would love to do that. So our team, that's a lot of work, filming, editing, mixing, post-production, pre-production, and then reading all those comments and talking to them, replying them. That's a lot of work. If any of you have worked with video, then you know how the video works and how hard it is or how time-consuming it is. So the team comprises of CEO, admin officer, business development officer, office assistant, director, production manager. More on the next slide. Yeah, producer, video editor, social media producer, and many more on the list. So that's our team. Kamal Kumar out there, and me myself. Okay, on the next slide, we have got our business card that was never printed, probably the most longest designation, probably the most longest business card with lots of designation. You can just read it out there. So that was just two of us doing almost everything for about 16 months. And now the story has a little bit changed. Yes. Now, we are trying and planning to divide our workload. So, we have got one producer in our team and two interns. I must say a little bit on this thing, because we have got lots and lots of media students out there, and they are really liking our stories and the way we are telling the stories of ordinary people. And we get lots and lots of messages from the younger generations, from the young people, from the younger students out there. And then we thought like, okay, let's have interns in our group. So we have decided to have two interns for 2 months. So they just come with us and work with us and read our comments and also make the short video stories for us and things like that. So that's how we do. And we are about to hire a business development officer very soon. Mm-hmm. And this has been possible because our value that never changes, that's people first. We just have people in our mind. We just have ordinary people's stories in our mind and nothing else. Mm-hmm. So our community is growing. In YouTube, it's 200,000 subscribers, as I have already mentioned. And in Facebook, I also have got Facebook. It has got almost like 200,000 followers. And Herne Katha, it has got around 100,000 followers. So that combines together 300,000 Facebook followers. And then Twitter, 40,000. That's also the combined one, myself and with Herne Katha. And on Instagram, we have got 27,000 followers. And it's growing. We really hope to see it. To go up there. Yes. And the audience, who are our audience? We have got global audience as well. We have got like 38% of Nepalese audience, and rest of the world is 62%. That's quite big. So the numbers varies from India to Asia to USA to Arab, because we have lots and lots of migrant workers working in our Arab countries. So we have got some from Poland as well. That's about 0.1%. And it's big for us, yes. We count that too. 0.1% is also very big. So on the next slide. Mm-hmm. People love our show. That's what I said, and that's the example. We just ask people, like, if you want it to make it global, then help us and contribute us in the subtitling. And almost 50% of our episodes have been subtitled by our audience. because we have enabled the community contributions and people have contributed it because they really wanted to show it to their family members who are living outside the countries or their friends and teachers and students and things like that. So they have helped us a lot. Mm-hmm. I will just move fast. So our current revenue, I have said that we are about to hire one producer, we are about to hire a business development officer, and that has been possible just because we have been funded now. A little bit of grant we have got from OSF. Thank you so much, OSF team. I'm not sure if they are here, but thank you so much for that. And then we are attracting advertisers as well. Though we are very independent, we don't let them influence what we do, but advertisers, they are also being quite interested. And as I said, YouTube earning is also giving us a little bit of more money. And then we are also trying to have crowdfunding. We have patron pays. You can just go to our pays, Rishad out there, and then Yakov, they are our proud patron. So you people, you also have got that opportunity. You can be our proud patron. And then we are also thinking of having the membership model. Mm-hmm. Okay, so our future revenue model will be less donor funded, more advertisers, more YouTube money, with more videos, of course. And because we have got team now, so we can have more videos as well. So we are thinking of having more YouTube earnings and more crowdfunding. And of course, we are thinking of like having the membership model as well, but it's just in our discussion. Yeah. And then that's the last one. I would really, really would like to request you to follow us on YouTube, check us on Patreon, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook page. And I just have one last slide out there. I'm just leaving it with it, with this slide. This is the glimpse. The other slide, that's dhanyavad is in Nepali language. Thank you. So after this, I have got one more slide. I'm just living with it. I'm not going to stay here for longer. Thank you so much. Wait. Thank you so much for having me here. And thank you so much for listening. I'm not telling lies, so thank you so much for listening my story, our story. Thank you so much. Yeah. So I'm leaving with the video. Yeah. This will give you the glimpse of what we do in Nepal. Talk, Sailor Mother.